This is a year 2000 Lexus RX300 with a Toyota 3.0 liter V6 1MZ-FE engine. This car is in the shop for a leak from the crankshaft seal, the front crankshaft seal. So in the process of fixing that leak and replacing the seal, we've also replaced the timing belt. So in this video, I'm showing you how to time the timing belt. I'm not showing you every single step of what you need to remove or what you need to unbolt. I'm just showing you how to time the timing, the valve timing, how to get the valve timing right with the engine in the car. Previously I did a video with the engine out of the car, showing this same thing, putting the timing belt on correctly. And some of the YouTube clowns suggested that I'm not able of doing this in the car, which is kind of ridiculous. But anyway, hey, proof's in the pudding. Here it is. Enjoy. I'm showing you the proper way to put the timing belt on. This is the lower timing mark. There is a indent on the reluctor wheel and it lines up with a very small little raised bump on the oil pump. Okay, and you can see them right there. Sort of hard to see, but that's what you gotta look for. The sprocket has an indentation right here that you use for lining up the mark on the timing belt. Let's zoom in on the timing mark on the left bank, bank two. See that the sprocket has a small indent, and that lines up with an indent on the rear timing cover. They're both marked. When you put the timing belt in place, the mark on the timing belt should line up with these two. Now we're looking at the marks on bank one, the right hand bank. These are a little bit more difficult to see, and I have the timing belt placed on there to help you see them. There's an indentation on the sprocket and it should line up with the indentation on the rear timing cover. To make absolutely sure that the timing is correct, I've taken out the old belt. I've made marks on the outside of the belt before removal. You can see these marks. This is the mark for the bottom pulley crankshaft. This is the mark for the front pulley, bank two. This is the mark for the rear pulley, bank one. Now, I have counted the teeth. Okay, I've counted the teeth, not on the belt, but the teeth that would correspond to the sprocket teeth. So between the bottom pulley and the front pulley, it's 77 teeth. Between the front pulley and the rear pulley, it is 59 teeth. And between the rear pulley and the bottom mark on the crankshaft, it was 75 teeth. Next we compare with the brand new belt, which is a Gates belt. This Gates belt has three marks on the crankshaft pulley position, which makes it very confusing. So which one of these marks should you use? Let's count teeth. So going from the crankshaft to the first mark in this direction, we get 77, which is same as what we had with the old belts. Just to confirm, we continue the count. We get 59 between pulleys, and continuing from the rear pulley down to the bottom, we have 75 to the same mark. So to get the correct timing, you use this mark and point the arrows towards the block. Now you could, if you wanted, flip this around just to confuse you, and instead of using this top mark that we've used for the count, use this bottom mark on the bottom pulley, and everything will come out okay. Okay, but you have to get it in the right direction or it will be off by two teeth. And the right direction is with these arrows on the timing mark on the bottom pulley. To get started, I have put the belt on the rear pulley. And I've lined up the mark with the pulley and with the rear timing cover. And to make absolutely sure that the belt does not move, I have clamped it in place with a C-clamp. Now I've done the same thing with the front sprocket. I've lined up the belt on the sprocket and the rear timing cover, and to make sure it goes absolutely nowhere, I put this little C-clamp on it. So now, looking from the bottom, if we were to just try to slip this belt on without any further ado, it would be off by one tooth. So we need to do a little bit of shimmying to get this in place. So using this big wrench, we've shimmied the bottom pulley just a little bit so that the timing marks all line up perfectly. Okay, and now we can finish by slipping the belt over the tensioner pulley. We've slipped the tensioner into place. Now we are going to use blue Loctite on the two bolts that hold the tensioner up into the assembly, just so they do not back out. Now the tensioner is bolted in place securely with Loctite on the two bolts. And not to forget this little guard that keeps the belt from bouncing around. And at this point, we have not pulled the pin on the tensioner. The belt is relatively tight. I'm going to go ahead and turn the crankshaft pulley, make sure that everything remains correct. Here's another view of our handiwork before we start turning. You can see all the marks are lined up. You can see the belt routing. And now we're gonna go ahead and turn it. We've turned the crankshaft two full revolutions. This mark on the block is lined up with the little dimple on the reluctor wheel. We've released the tensioner. The marks up top are all in the right place, take my word for it. So we're good to go. Hope this has been helpful to you. Thank you for watching.